The Venezuelan government has banned opposition protests ahead of a vote on Sunday on a new assembly tasked with writing a new constitution. President Nicolas Maduro says the move is a necessary step to restoring stability. But the opposition is boycotting the vote, claiming the assembly will be filled with the president's supporters and will turn the country into a dictatorship.
The capitalist block, large at least, if not all of the capital, large chunks of the capital are blocked. Demonstrations are out in force. Demonstrators are out in force. According to the Attorney General's office, we have had 112 demonstrators and security forces killed since April 6th. But there's another NGO called Control Ciudadano, which has an even bigger fatality tally. 134 fatalities since April 1st. So by any account, it's been very, very serious.
We asked a former Venezuelan envoy to the UN and an American journalist covering the situation in the country for their views on the pre-election unrest.
The purpose is not only to write the constitution. The purpose is to get rid of the National Assembly, which we won with 2/3 of the vote. That's precisely the reason. And they have now about 85% rejection of the regime. So they have resorted to this illegal, fraudulent, and unconstitutional modality.
There was a presidential election in 2018 where Maduro is going to be up for vote and the opposition is going to run for president, regardless of the outcome of the Constituent Assembly. It's an open democratic process. The opposition can run their own candidates and they can participate in it. But they've called to boycott it instead of taking part. And if they have the majority, as they say they do, they could easily run, win a majority of constituents, and change the constitution how they want to see it changed. Instead, they've opposed a democratic process and called for violence in the streets as a response.
This is not a democratic election. We are not boycotting. We're just not trying to legitimize a fraudulent, unconstitutional, an illegal modality. That's what's really happening.
In recent talks between U.S. Vice President and the Venezuelan opposition leader Leopoldo Lopez, Washington has suggested it's ready to impose new sanctions in response to Maduro's actions here. Could this not be interpreted as undue interference in the political process of a foreign country, Mr. Prisner?
Oh, it absolutely is. Beyond that, I mean, the CIA has been uncovered saying that they want to determine the outcome of the political process in Venezuela. They have long been funding to the tune of millions and millions and millions of U.S. taxpayer dollars to opposition parties, to opposition movements. No one wants U.S. intervention. Even members of the opposition that I spoke to do not want the U.S. to intervene.
This is precisely the regime's propaganda. Going to what you call intervention, it's not only the United States. Now Mexico announced it, the United Kingdom, the European Parliament. Why? In the last 112 days, 107 Venezuelans have lost their lives, fundamentally young people. About 1,500 have been wounded, and we have almost 2,000 people in jail. That has been the price of a civic protest in Venezuela.
This is just another lie that is just spit constantly to justify foreign intervention in the country. The vast majority of those deaths, that over 100 deaths, are caused by opposition violence. Over a dozen assassinations by opposition protesters against people just for supporting the government. I mean, do you condemn those horrible political lynchings, sir? Do you condemn those horrific political assassinations?
We are a peaceful opposition. The whole world recognizes the European Union. It's not only the United States. 20 countries in Latin America. The people are being killed. Now it happens now that they say they have been killed by our own people. That's really rubbish, and I think it's very unfair to say.
The capitalist block, large at least, if not all of the capital, large chunks of the capital are blocked. Demonstrations are out in force. Demonstrators are out in force. According to the Attorney General's office, we have had 112 demonstrators and security forces killed since April 6th. But there's another NGO called Control Ciudadano, which has an even bigger fatality tally, 134 fatalities since April 1st. So by any account, it's been very, very serious.
We asked a former Venezuelan envoy to the UN and an American journalist covering the situation in the country for their views on the pre-election unrest.
The purpose is not only to write the constitution. The purpose is to get rid of the National Assembly, which we won with two-thirds of the vote. That's precisely the reason. And they have now about 85% rejection of the regime. So they have resorted to this illegal, fraudulent, and unconstitutional modality.
There's a presidential election in 2018 where Maduro is going to be up for vote and the opposition is going to run for president, regardless of the outcome of the Constituent Assembly. It's an open
foreign country, Mr. Prisner.
Oh, it absolutely is. Beyond that, I mean, the CIA has been uncovered, saying that they want to determine the outcome of the political process in Venezuela. They have long been funding to the tune of millions and millions and millions of U.S. taxpayer dollars to opposition parties, to opposition movements. No one wants U.S. intervention. Even members of the opposition that I spoke to do not want the U.S. to intervene.
It is precisely the regime's propaganda. Going to what you call intervention, it's not only the United States. Now Mexico announced it, the United Kingdom, the European Parliament. Why? In the last 112 days, 107 Venezuelans have lost their lives, fundamentally young people, about 1,500.
The Venezuelan government has banned opposition protests ahead of a vote on Sunday on a new assembly tasked with writing a new constitution. President Nicolas Maduro says the move is a necessary step to restoring stability, but the opposition is boycotting the vote, claiming the assembly will be filled with the president's supporters and will turn the country into a dictatorship.
Democratic process, the opposition can run their own candidates and they can participate in it, but they've called to boycott it instead of taking part in it. If they have the majority, as they say they do, they could easily run, win a majority of constituents, and change the constitution how they want to see it change. Instead, they've opposed a democratic process and called for violence in the streets as a response.
This is not a democratic election. We are not boycotting. We're just not trying to legitimize a fraudulent, unconstitutional, an illegal modality. That's what's really happening.
In recent talks between U.S. Vice President and the Venezuelan opposition leader Leopoldo Lopez, Washington has suggested it's ready to impose new sanctions in response to Maduro's actions here. Could this not be interpreted as undue interference in the political process of